Diana, some 15,000 people with Pakistani heritage live right here in Metro Detroit, and they're really hoping this turns the page on the homeland they love so much. Mohammad Kazi is the chairman of the Council on Pakistan Relations, which is based in Washington, D.C. He's also the CEO of Sienna Healthcare and works here in Metro Detroit. And he hopes the death of Osama bin Laden will lead to a better life for the people of Pakistan.
Many times people are afraid to go out. It gets after a suicide bombing. You know, it's unfortunately there's been so many that it's become somewhat part of a routine in that country. But it has had a very devastating impact, a psychological impact. People don't feel safe.
Kazi, who left Pakistan in 1981 and emigrated to Woodhaven, still has many family members in Pakistan. He says he hopes they and their fellow citizens will be able to live in the land he remembers as a child.
That's how I remember it, as a moderate country where you did not have these jihadist groups who are basically ready to kill you if you don't agree with them. It is a conservative country. It's not a very liberal country. It never was, but it was nothing like what we have right now.
His goal with the Council on Pakistan Relations is to improve the relationship between the U.S. and Pakistan and to end the mistrust. And he knows with Osama bin Laden having been hiding almost in plain sight, there will be questions about the complicity of the Pakistani people or government in protecting him.
There are certainly lots of questions that are unanswered. Certainly we hope that at the end of the day, yes, it is perhaps looked at as an oversight or weakness in Pakistan's, on Pakistan's part, rather than complicity.
Kazi says that Pakistanis themselves have also paid the price, that by some estimates, some 30,000 have been killed at the hands of Osama bin Laden and Al-Qaeda. We're live in Southfield this evening. I'm Michael Rosenfield, Channel 7 Action News.